You're listening to Talk the Bible, where we relate the Bible to current issues, because the Bible says there's nothing new under the sun.
Hello, welcome to Talk the Bible. Austin is my name. The Bible said that there's nothing new under the sun. Please listen to me. The Bible is correct. The Bible is true. Nothing that you are saying today that is new under the sun. They are not new to this earth. All the violence, all the confusion, you see the destruction of innocent life, you see the killing, you see the agony that is going on in our society, you see the mourning and the grieving that is going on in our society. All these are not strange to this earth. The Bible is very correct about it. They are not strange to this earth. Proverbs 29 verse 2 says, when the wicked rules, the people suffer. The people that they rule, they grieve, they mourn, and they suffer. So the Bible is telling us that there are people that are wicked. There are people that the Bible classifies wicked. And if those people rule a nation or rule people, the people that they rule, they suffer. So the question is this: who are these wicked? Who are the people that the Bible regard as wicked? The people that the Bible regarded as wicked are those who rejected the word of God, those who refused to obey the word of God, those who placed themselves in the position of God, those who exalt themselves because of their position and begin to make a decision without respect for the word of God. The Bible says when those people rule, the people that they rule, they suffer. They suffer. One may ask, how will people mourn or grieve or suffer because their leader rejected the word of God? Proverbs 6 verse 12 to 14 say, the wicked, let me tell you who are the wicked, why people will suffer. The wicked goes around saying twisting things with their mouth. The wicked, they goes around saying twisting things. They lie with their mouth. They set confusion among the people that they rule with their mouth. They wink with their eyes. They are very charismatic. If you see them, they are outspoken. They know how to speak. They wink with their eyes. They make signal with their feet. They motion with their finger. They know how to talk. And what did they say? They're going around twisting words, lying to set confusion. The Bible says they stir up discord. They cause confusion. They cause division among those people that they rule. This is why the people will suffer, because what they specialize in doing, the wicked leaders, is to set confusion among their people, the people that they rule. They set them against themselves. They cause violence. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs chapter 10 verse 11 say, their mouth is full of violence. They speak a word that causes violence. Look at what is going on in our society today. Does it familiar? You see all the violence that is going on in our country today? The Bible just gives you a description of the wicked that the Bible is talking about. It says when these people rule, the people suffer. And the reason is because instead of them bringing people together, they cause confusion. They divide people. They speak lie. They are very outspoken. They are very eloquence. They speak eloquency. When you see the way they speak, they demonstrate. They wink their eyes. They use their feet. They use their finger to demonstrate. They are very passionate of what they are saying, the lie that they are promoting. Does this familiar today? Look at our leaders. You see how they lie to us? You see how they set confusion? You see the racism in our country today? All this is as a result of the leaders that we have, the wicked leaders. They have succeeded in causing confusion. That's why you see killing of police officers. You see police officers killing people because of the spirit of the leaders. The Bible says when the wicked rule, the people suffer. the people suffer. Our leaders are wicked today. Our leaders rejected God today. Let me be clear to you. I know some of you will not like me in this. Since our president took over, all the things that he promoted go against God. Sometimes I wonder whether if the president respect God, did he know that there's God, the one that gave him life, the one that wakes him up every day, the one that gave him strength to do all the things that he's doing? I don't think the president ever think about that. See all his agenda. He is the only president that promotes gay since he became, since 2011, he has changed the ordinances of marriage without no regard for the one that created marriage. He's the one that went to the women's right, the abortion right, and begin to promote abortion. Say, oh, we have done well, but we still have a long way to go. Killing of innocent baby. Mr. President, what is going on? Mr. President, you need to sit down and think. Look at your regime. I call it regime because I don't even know whether you are a democratic elected president anymore, because you make a decision without even thinking. You don't even care about the law. Look at your administration with due respect. Ask yourself, why is all this thing happening in your time? Why is people killing people? Why people using gun to kill people? Before you became president, there's gun in America. People don't use it. Why gun is so rampant? Why? You see all this confusion. How do you feel as the president? Because this will be your legacy. The Bible says when the wicked rule, people suffer. When the wicked rule, people suffer, because the wicked carry spirit of division, spirit of violence, spirit of confusion. And that is what is happening today. So if you value this nation, if you concern about the life that have been destroyed, please listen to me. Election is coming. Look at these people. As the Bible says, the wicked are those who rejected the word of God. Those who have no regard to the word of God. Who have no respect to God. And you see what is going on today. Do you want innocent people to continue dying under these wicked people? Or you want to put a stop to it? Let me talk about the consequence that is coming to those wicked people. If you are a wicked leader, you might be the president of the United States of America. You might be the judges, the Supreme Court judges who have no regard for God. You might be the governor. You might be whoever you are. Listen to me. The Bible says that there's a punishment coming. In the book of Isaiah chapter 3 verse 11 say, woe to the wicked. Disaster is upon them. They will pay back for what their hands have done. Let me tell you, any of you that are be the reason why all this thing that is happening, killing of police officer, killing of innocent soul, all these people that are contributed, all the wicked people that have lied, using the media to lie, using their office to lie, the Bible says you will pay back. Disaster is coming upon you. And I stand on the word of God tonight. I say disaster shall come upon you. Every innocent soul that have been lost as a result of your lie, it shall come upon you. You shall run when no one pursue you. The Bible says the wicked shall have no peace. And I declare under that word of God that the wicked in this nation shall have no peace. They will run when no one pursue them. In the night, they shall have no peace. In the day, they shall have no peace. The voices of the weak, the innocent blood shall chase them. In their office, they shall have no peace. The wicked that they have caused shall fall upon them. The Bible says, calamity shall come suddenly. Suddenly shall they be broken without no reward. I declare, so shall it be. Every wicked one in America, calamity shall come upon you. Disaster shall come upon you, upon your family. You shall have no peace. In the name of Jesus Christ, you shall be terrified day and night until you stop and repent. I declare, so shall it be in Jesus' name. Amen. I will talk to you next time. Bye-bye. If you like this message, subscribe, make comment, join me, to stand for the word of God. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.